Hello children. In our previous class, we studied about the introduction to history and the topic when. Our today's topic is where. Where exactly the historical events take place. To begin with the topic, history is studied geographically. That is, the historical events are being influenced by the geographical features like landforms, water bodies, deserts, forests, plains, etc. To be very clear, based on the geographical feature, the historical events vary. And geography is studied historically. That is, from the ancient period to the present date, we have seen and faced so many changes around us as well as in the earth. So, these changes of the earth are to be studied with respect to history. That is why it is given as geography is studied historically. Okay? The geographical physical divisions of India influenced many historical events. These helped the people for the following. First, hunting. Hunting people did to fetch their food as well as to protect them from enemies. Migration. In the ancient history, the people had a nomadic life and people migrated or moved from one place to another. This migration was also influenced by the geographical feature. Settlements. If ancient people had got proper resources for them to live, that is, proper place to survive, proper food to have, proper water resource, the people might have settled in that particular place. Next, wars. The period as well as the purpose of wars depended on the geographical feature of the place. Trade. During the ancient period, many people were traders. So, the geographical features was helpful for the people to manufacture the goods or to transport the goods from one place to another and to even sell them to the proper place. Thus, the physical features helped the ancient people for the above. The physical divisions of ancient India. Himalayas, northern plains and the water bodies around India. The Himalayas in the north and the northeastern part of India helped us to protect our motherland from enemies. That is, the worst climate of Himalayas prevented the entry of enemies into India. The northern plains. The northern plains were very fertile, that people living in the plains cultivated crops and performed with farming. The people had surplus amount of food, water and traded using barter system in the northern plains. The water bodies around India, especially Arabian Sea on the west of India, Bay of Bengal on the east of India and Indian Ocean to the south of India. These water bodies made the coastal plains as well as the coastal lands fertile and easy for transportation of goods as well as people. But during the early ancient period and in the mid ancient period, people did not use these water bodies for transportation and felt that these water bodies protected them from enemies. On the map, you will be able to see the Himalayan ranges that protected us from enemies in the north. The northern plains, which were very fertile with all the water resources, which helped the people to cultivate crops. The water bodies, Arabian Sea, Indian Ocean and Bay of Bengal protected us from enemies and made the coastal plains also fertile. On the left hand side image, you will be able to see the satellite image of India. Moving on to next topic, as everybody of us will be having so many names. So we will be having a name in the school, we will be having name among our friends, we will be having name among our family groups, etc. Similarly, India in ancient times also had certain different names. Hodu is a biblical Hebrew name for India and is mentioned in the Old Testament. Tianzu. Initially, the river Indus was called as Sindhu. The Persian rulers changed the name as Hindu from Sindhu. So, the name was changed from Sindhu to Hindu. Later, the Chinese and the Japanese called India as Tianzu. Tianzu means it is a translation of the word Hindu. Okay? Then the Persians, Iranians and the Greeks referred India as Hindo or Indos. Bharat, it is the official name of India and is also believed to be mentioned in the Rig Veda of the Hindu mythology.